Hello everyone, this is Prajwal and in this video I'll cover the steps to perform SCCM 2107 upgrade. Microsoft released SCCM 2107 on August 2nd, 2021 and you can perform SCCM 2107 upgrade on sites that run Configuration Manager version 2002 or later. Configuration Manager 2107 is the second current branch update of year 2021. The version 2107 has a meaning behind it. 21 is year 2021 and 07 is the July month. SCCM 2107 is available in the early update ring and you must run the early update ring script to see 2107 update appear in the console. SCCM 2107 is not a baseline version. If you are installing a new SCCM site, Configuration Manager 2103 baseline should be used. SCCM 2107 Prerequisites. I would want you to refer my SCCM 2107 upgrade post to know about prerequisites. I have linked the post in the video description. To summarize, here are some of the prerequisites. First of all, the update 2107 is available as an in-console update and should be available under Updates and Servicing node of Configuration Manager console. To upgrade to version 2107, ensure you are running SCCM version 2002 or later. Apply the version 2107 update starting at the top level site in the hierarchy. First, perform the CAS upgrade. Later, you can begin the upgrade of each child site. Complete the upgrade of each site before you begin the upgrade to the next site. Ensure that you are running a supported operating system version and SQL Server version. More details about it can be found on the Microsoft site. If there is a pending restart for a server, reboot the server and then begin the update installation. And lastly, the SCCM version should have an online service connection point. One of the common questions asked before upgrade is, should I install the previous SCCM hotfixes before SCCM 2107 upgrade? The answer is no. That's because all previous Configuration Manager hotfixes will be included in SCCM 2107 release. Step 1. Download SCCM 2107 Enable Early Update Ring script. Before you begin the SCCM 2107 upgrade, to get the 2107 update in the console, you must run the Early Update Ring script. Download the version 2107 opt-in script first. Save the script to a folder on the site server. You must extract the contents before you get the script to run. Step 2. Run SCCM 2107 Enable Early Update Ring PowerShell script. Until the SCCM 2107 is generally available, you must run the PowerShell script to get the 2107 update. To do that, close the Configuration Manager console. On your SCCM server, run the PowerShell as administrator. Change the path to the script location. And run the Enable Early Update Ring 2107 script. Enter the site server name, which is the top level site server name or IP address. And the script downloads the update 2107 in console for you. After you run the above script, the update 2107 starts to download. You can monitor the download process by reviewing the dmpdownloader.log. During the update download, the 2107 update status shows as downloading. Once the download is complete, you should see the state as ready to install. Step 3. SCCM 2107 upgrade, run prerequisite check. You must always run prerequisite check before installing a major SCCM update. You may see some warnings or even errors that could prevent installing the update. Since SCCM version 2107 includes new prerequisite check warnings, I highly recommend running prerequisite check. To run SCCM 2107 prerequisite check, launch the Configuration Manager console. Navigate to Administration, Overview, Updates and Servicing node. Right-click Configuration Manager 2107 update and click Run Prerequisite Check. After you run the prerequisite check, it takes a while to actually begin the checks. The update state changes to checking prerequisites. You'll see the update status as checking prerequisites for a long time. You can monitor the prerequisite checks either in the monitoring workspace or review the config.mgr prerequisite.log. The status of update prerequisite check is shown in updates and servicing node. You can check the prerequisite check status by monitoring the update pack installation status. In the Configuration Manager console, go to Monitoring, Overview, Updates and Servicing Status. Right-click Configuration Manager 2107 Update and click Show Status. After the prerequisite check is complete, I'm sure you'll see a common warning. Configuration Manager 2107 includes a new prerequisite check warning about .NET Framework 4.8. Configuration Manager now requires Microsoft .NET Framework version 4.6.2 for site servers, specific site systems, clients, and the console. Before you run the setup to install or update the site, first update .NET Framework and restart the system. If possible, in your environment, install the latest version of .NET version 4.8. This warning should appear for everyone unless you have installed .NET Framework 4.8 framework on your site servers. You may actually ignore this warning because it will not halt your SCCM 2107 upgrade. However, if you want to avoid seeing this warning in the next update, it is recommended that you download and install .NET Framework 4.8 and then run the update or install the update. I'll cover more about this warning in my next video. Step 4, SCCM 2107 upgrade. Let's begin the SCCM 2107 upgrade. Launch the SCCM console. Navigate to Administration, Overview, Updates and Servicing node. Right-click Configuration Manager 2107 Update and click Install Update Pack. On the general window of Configuration Manager Updates wizard, click Next. The Configuration Manager 2107 update includes Configuration Manager Site Server Updates, Configuration Manager Console Updates, Configuration Manager Client Updates, Fixes for Known Issues, and New Features. On the Features window, you will see some new features included with the current update. You can enable the features after the 2107 update installation from Updates and Servicing node of the console. Click Next. Choose your preferred client update settings and click Next. Accept the license terms and click Next. On the summary window, click Next. And on the completion window, click Close. Now all you need to do is wait for the 2107 update to install. The SCCM version 2107 upgrade usually takes 45 minutes or sometimes even more than that to complete. During the upgrade, do not perform any changes to your setup using Configuration Manager console. Just leave the server idle and let the update install. Step 5, monitor SCCM 2107 upgrade process. After you begin the SCCM 2107 upgrade, you can monitor the SCCM 2107 upgrade process with the following steps. In SCCM console, go to Monitoring node, click Overview, and then select Updates and Servicing Status. Select the Configuration Manager 2107 update and click Show Status. Now you must ensure all the steps show as completed. Step 6, SCCM 2107 console upgrade. After the update installs, a new version of Configuration Manager console will be installed. you cannot skip the console upgrade process. To upgrade the console to the latest version, you can either refresh the console once or close and launch the console. A console upgrade window pops up, and all you have to do is click OK to begin the console upgrade. After upgrading to Configuration Manager 2107, the new console version will be 5.2107.1059.2000. Step 7. Verify SCCM 2107 upgrade. After the console upgrade, you can check the following details to confirm if the 2107 upgrade is completed successfully. In the Configuration Manager console, click About Configuration Manager. You should see the following: Microsoft Endpoint Configuration Manager version 2107, console version 5.2107.1059.2000, and site version 5.0.9058.1000. So that completes the SCCM 2107 upgrade. I hope this video helps you. Hit the like button and subscribe to my YouTube channel. I'll see you all with my next video soon. Bye.